Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, and we are continuing. We are now in the third section of the primary closet. So I divided this into three sections after realizing the first section took us about an hour, 15, hour and a half, and then we just finished the second, so now we're on the third and final, and we'll film what we can today. So if you're decluttering, watch the series of just so you have someone with you, decluttering with you, motivating you. We are downsizing the house, and so this is one of the last sections inside the house that we have to take care of. Then we still have the backyard and the garage. So let's start. I think I'm going to start with the drawers here, then move to the, it's very dusty in here, and then move to the shelves. Probably go from bottom to top, or I'll just check. This is actually empty, but I'll just show you that. Then we'll go here, and then that's the last thing I honestly... That and then these papers, those papers are the last things I want to do. So what I'm doing sometimes, like with paperwork, I'm just putting them in a box and we're bringing them to the storage unit. I have that video up here just to show you what that looks like so far, or in the beginning. And the reason a friend told me go ahead and get a storage unit, because you don't have, if you can't make all the decisions now, especially with important paperwork or just paperwork or all the little itty bitty stuff or even sentimental things, put them in the storage unit, take care of the house, and then you can go to the storage unit and deal with it then. So that's my advice to you also. Okay, my husband is going up to see if they put anything up there. Usually in Phoenix, something like that is just for AC access, but of course, you could always find things up there. Okay, good thing there is nothing up there. Okay, so these are all pretty much throw or Goodwill. You can see there's nothing in here, nothing in here. We have some photos down here in the corner, so we'll just bring those. And we are having a junk removal company that will eventually come. Oh, this is jewelry. And take all these, like this file cabinet and larger pieces of furniture. What they do is they try to sell it. Oh, sorry about that. That's my mic. They try to sell it, and if they can, that's great for them. If not, then, bottom line, we have a way to let go of the bigger pieces of furniture. Okay, I usually start from top to bottom, but because there are those big boxes in there and probably little tchotchkes in there, I'm gonna go ahead and start from here, because if these are shoes, they're basically Goodwill or throw, because my mom said that she doesn't want any more shoes. Let's see. Oh, more bears and bowls. Yes. Oh, look. It's branded. Huh? I'll keep these. These are keep. Thank you. Okay, so now we're gonna work on this final part here. I think it's actually been a week. We had to leave earlier last times, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and tackle this part because for me, paper is my arch nemesis, but I'm gonna make it happen. Okay, so these are a bunch of medical papers, but it's like from 9-10 years ago. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and keep them, put them in the storage unit. And so when I go through all the paperwork, I'll do it then. Because this is gonna take me, I mean, it might just take me 20 minutes to take care of this, but we just, you know, this is something I can do later. It doesn't have to be done now. I just need this out of the house. And since we have the storage unit, that's a feasible system or process that I can go through. Okay, we'll just pause right here before the last drawer. So what I've done is these are all mainly clothes, and because we've already decently filled my mom's closet, which is a walk-in closet at her new place. I mean, she has all the pants, sweaters, shirts, undergarments that she needs and shoes. We just got a few more things from here that I think she would like. But so that's kind of my measuring. I don't know if you call it a measuring stick, or this is kind of my guideline, is that her closet is already full. So anything else I'm gonna bring in, it's either there's still a little bit of space. I mean, it's not overstuffed, but there is just enough space, or I'm gonna end up being the one storing it. So that's why we're being pretty ruthless as far as the clothing. And the clothing that I feel like we can sell, or not sell, that we can donate at Goodwill, that's what we're taking. And the rest we're just getting rid of. Okay, friends, this is the primary closet. It's all empty. I'll just give you a little overview. So that was section one. This was section two. And then section three. This is the before. And then this is the after. Before. And after. Before. And after. Friends, we are done with the inside of the house. So make sure to watch the playlist. Hit the next video because we are going to do the backyard. After that, the garage. And then I have the handyman coming today. So he's gonna check out all the things he needs to repair. We're gonna have the junk removal people come after the backyard and garage. And then the carpet cleaners, the floor cleaners, the cleaners. And we'll see if we have to repaint. So I'll do a walkthrough of the whole house
and even the outside before we put on the market. And if you are decluttering or downsizing, watch the playlist. Hope it gives you some motivation. Know that you're not alone. Yes, this is a hard process, but it is something, it is a process that you can get through. All right, see you in the next one. If you need help decluttering, I've created a free PDF checklist, 24 things to declutter. They're quick and easy and probably things you've been thinking about letting go of. Well, here's your sign to do so. Click the link in the show notes below, put in your email, and you'll receive the download immediately. You've got this.